आई एम अ वॉलंटियर ऑफ सहयोग फॉर कोविड रिलीफ फूड सेल. अच्छा लगता है.
आई एम अ वॉलंटियर ऑफ सहयोग फॉर कोविड रिलीफ फूड सेवा. अच्छा लगता है.
आई एम अ वॉलंटियर ऑफ सहयोग कोविड रिलीफ फूड सेवा. अच्छा लगता है.
आई एंड माई हस्बैंड आर वॉलंटियर विद सहयोग फॉर कोविड रिलीफ फूड सेवा. अच्छा लगता है.
Hello all. In the times of unprecedented rise in the cases of COVID in Delhi, many good Samaritans jumped in and took upon themselves to help those around them. Three shining stars among them are Mr. Sumit Singh, Mr. Ashish Chhabra, and Ms. Sonia Manwani. They used the various skills to design a system of providing food to patients in home isolation with the very nice system of volunteers who would cook, and they would send, you know, instead of me talking about it, I would request them to, you know, talk about this. So first of all, welcome to this episode, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you,
Raja.
Okay, so, you know, I would first request Mr. Sumit to answer this question. You know, could you please tell the viewers about the service that you're running? What made you start it? What's the background? Tell us about it.
Well, initially at the onset of this COVID lockdown happening last year, we started with providing free meals, to the people who were daily wagers. So last year, me and Ashish, we kind of initiated a campaign where we would, have food cooked across through a picture or at one point, particular point of a Gurudwara or some place, and we used to collect that food and take it to the slums and the other areas where these people would live under the flyovers, the beggars, and all the different kind of people who were living on a day-to-day basis and were dependent upon other people to provide them with their daily bread. So anybody who was living under the flyover or was working in a factory who was earning a daily wage was deprived of food at that point in time. And we thought that it would be a good idea. So we started by, initiating a WhatsApp campaign and then spread it across. And it's been going on, since then, whenever the lockdown. This year, however, we come across, because there was the Corona pandemic was at its peak, and we were having a lot of trouble in going out ourselves because, our families were also at risk. So we took the digital path here and we started collecting volunteers from different parts of Delhi. And now these volunteers are cooking foods for patients who are near to their houses. And that's how we, get the pickup done. And
So, thank you, Sumitji. I'm going to now ask Ashish ji, who's, going to tell what you already started, Sumitji, the process, the detailed process in which, the order is received by you people and what are the steps involved? How does that food finally reach the person who has ordered food, from the seva that you're running?
Okay, the process is very simple. A person needs to dial a predefined number, which is mentioned into our poster or our WhatsApp message. Okay, the person has to dial that number and he or she has to request the number of patients, like how many patients they have into their family or how many family members they have. Okay, they tell us that, and on the basis of that, we assign a volunteer which is nearer to that particular address. For example, somebody is into South Delhi, and so we try to assign a person who is from South Delhi only, so that the riding cost is taken care of.
Absolutely.
So after we assign a volunteer, the volunteer take care of that particular family, he or she cook the food at us for his own home, and then he had scored the food to the rider, and the rider comes and picks up the food and collects the food and deliver it to the particular family who has been affected by COVID.
Great, sir. So, Miss Sonia, I want to ask you this question. I've heard about so many langars being given, so many restaurants, so many big hotels also providing food. But what is unique about this service? How is it different from the other, different models and different ways of providing food that exist, ma'am?
Yeah, see, many people are giving food right now. And the only difference in our service is that, what is the difference? You tell me, what is the difference between home-cooked dal chawal and butter chicken in the restaurant?
Absolutely.
See, you can't survive on that. So yes. That is the difference between our service, and that is the difference between what we are doing. We are giving food to the people from our own kitchen. What we eat, what is required at that time, they are meant to keep high protein and low calorie diet. So that's what we are providing. We are cooking ourselves. Our volunteers are cooking ourselves. So whatever they are cooking for themselves, they are providing that too. So there is a big difference between commercial kitchen and a regular kitchen. So that is the difference. That is the uniqueness.
That's a big difference. That's a big difference. And, you know, because so many volunteers are involved, it's a micro level process from the grassroots. I want to ask Ashish ji, how do the volunteers feel after being part of this service? Is it a fulfilling experience for them? How do they feel? Tell us about it.
They feel very happy. Of course, they feel like they are helping some humanity, or they have got a chance to help humanity. Now it's their time to pay back to the society. So they feel like, okay, it's a cause and we have to stand united. So they are united by heart now. Now they are following the social distancing formula, but yes, they are united by heart now.
You know, I was seeing the photographs with Sumit ji was sharing on WhatsApp, you know, people writing sticky notes along with the, you know, dishes and, you know, sending love along with the food, which is a very big deal. So Sumit ji, I want to ask you, do the people who prepare the dishes and the people who consume them have some communication? Do they directly communicate through each other, or is it like an anonymous system? How does it work?
So what the idea is that we would assign a volunteer to a patient close by to him, and then the patient can connect with the volunteer and tell him his food preference, whether he would want more or less a spice, or he would want anything else in specific particular to his regular meal, you know, regular diet. And if the volunteer is able to provide that, then the patient is more than welcome to. And if there's anyways, there's no other specific requirement by the volunteer or demand by the volunteer to the patient.
Great, great. So, Sonia ma'am, I want to ask this question, you know, like if you would ask me to help other people in this corona situation, you know, people are scared. People are afraid they can get corona. So how does this service take care of the precautions, you know, that are needed to prevent any infection so that people can do seva while being safe?
See, there is no direct connection between the COVID patient and the volunteer. So volunteers just cook the food in their houses. They use all the sanitization process. They wear masks, they wear gloves while cooking. And a rider comes at their house. They collect the parcel. And then he can't even touch the parcel. That is what it instructed to the rider. And then they deliver the food to the COVID patient. And there is no direct connection between the rider and the COVID patient. They just leave the parcel outside their doors. So that's how we secure the safety of the volunteers and the riders and the COVID patients as well.
That's a very beautifully integrated system where you use, you know, different services, a different riding service, different volunteer, and a different person who needs to be served. And, you know, you managing this, you know, sitting at a place, it really means a lot. You know, so about the delivery, Sumit ji, I want to ask you, how does this delivery happen? You know, are you tied up with some delivery company? Is it a paid model? Does the person who's a patient pay for only the delivery? How does it work, sir?
There is no direct, request from the patient that we make for paying for the food. But there are a lot of patients who are from well-to-do families, and it's not somebody providing them with a donation kind of, food. So if they are willing, they pay for that particular delivery. If they are not, we are more than happy to pay for the delivery. The food is anyways prepared by the volunteers at their home alongside, in addition to the meals that they are preparing for themselves. So these volunteers are very more than happy to actually be serving food, which they themselves are eating, and serve it to somebody else. One or two thalis for 7 or 8 days or maybe 15 days does not matter much. But it gives a great feeling of satisfaction to these volunteers that they're serving COVID patients in such a manner, and that to unknown people.
Okay.
It's a great deal of satisfaction. There's no charges as such. We use services of these food delivery companies, basically, which are providing delivery through applications. So we have Papos, we have Swiggy, we've got Lala Move, VFast, and other quick move courier services which are helping us with this.
Great, great. So Ashish ji, how many people have been touched by this service? You know, you're working for a long time. I'm seeing every day Sumit ji putting on his WhatsApp status about the food service. So how many deliveries have been made and how many volunteers have been involved?
Okay, I'll tell you that. We started with 4 volunteers, me, Sumit, Sonia, and one of our friends, Divya. Okay, now we have got around 52 volunteers with us who are working on this particular tema. And on an average, we get around 10 to 12 calls per day. And since 20 days, we are catering. So around 300 to 400 deliveries, we have already done that. Or rather, we have catered 300 to 400 families now. Okay. So it's a quite big number.
Absolutely. It's a big number. 300 to 400 families.
We started with 4 people and now we are almost 52 volunteers now.
That's amazing. 4 people to 52 volunteers. You know, 300 and more families that have been affected. That's great. Right. So, you know, in this process, there would be so many challenges that you face. So, Sonia ji, what were the challenges that you faced and what is the kind of support that is needed to run this service in the future? And what will be the transformation of the service? I'm sure, you know, you have created this very nice system. What are you going to do with this system after the pandemic is over?
See, we had initially, when we started, as Ashish ji just said, that we had started with only 4 volunteers. Now we have 52 volunteers who are working together. So initially there was problems of riders, there were problems of delivery. Since we had so many limited number of volunteers, the first call which we received was from Faridabad. And though there was just one volunteer, and Faridabad is a very big city, so the distance between the volunteer and the patient was quite far. And there was no riders available in Faridabad. So that was the initial challenges which we are facing. Slowly and steadily, we streamlined it. We got Papos joined with us, who gave free delivery for 20 days to our patients. And then there were many other companies started pitching in, like CP Spices, who gave spices to our volunteers. And currently, yes, we are working. We are getting more and more volunteers. We need more and more volunteers so that we can, you know, shorter the distance between the patient and the volunteer as well. And once this pandemic is over, what we have seen from this pandemic, that there are many senior citizens living in our country whose children are living or settled abroad, or even if they are in the same city, they are not able to help their parents. So to extend the services, we have, you know, seen, or we are working on this model to work for the senior citizens who are living alone, who need somebody to help them. They need very basic things. I mean, they have house, they have money, they have everything, but they need support from youngsters. They need just a ride to the doctor, or maybe, you know, they are not very good in technicalities. They are not very good in taking online orders. They can't put an order on Amazon or maybe do a Paytm to somebody. So we are thinking that since we have a good bunch of volunteers now, we will extend our services to senior citizens, that they can, we can give help to those senior citizens in small things which they required in their daily lives.
Amazing, ma'am. Amazing. So, you know, you've covered a lot about your service, you know, and, you know, I must congratulate you. You know, you have the blessing of God because you're running such a beautiful service, which is actually helping a lot of patients, you know, who probably had no support at that time. You know, people, I know a lot of people who were corona positive at home. They were eating bread every day, 3 times a day. It was not a very good experience for them. So, you know, thank you for doing this service. And, you know, because this is a good platform, all the viewers who are watching this, I would request Sumit ji to please give a message to all the viewers so that they can, you know, help you in some way, or, you know, do something for this good mission.
Well, thanks. I believe our team is continuously in search of volunteers who are looking forward to give even the slightest, even an ounce of time of, you know, out of their busy schedules to provide us with some kind of work. So I know that there's the pandemic and I know people cannot go out, and we're not looking very much for monetary contributions. Of course, money happens to be a part of it, but we do not outwardly go outside and ask money from any of the volunteers. We want people to be play a participative role in this. If they can help anybody who's nearby by cooking a chapati or two, you know, and providing even a single meal, our organization is more than dedicated and more than willing to provide them with the facilities of pick up and drop, and that too in the most safest and most exclusive pandemic-free environment, in a place where we would not be having any sanitization issues or anything which could lead them to be affected. I understand that people are very scared right now, but since we cannot come out physically, it is time to come out digitally and, you know, join the cause. And you can anyways get in touch with us. You have our details already. So that is all I would request, and that people to help each other and be a part of this campaign as much as possible.
So to all the viewers, the details of this organization is right there in the description below in the video. So I request you all to please contribute in whichever way you can to make this organization even more of a success, so that more and more people can be helped. And, you know, I really would pray to God that all our three people here, Sumit ji, Sonia ji, and Ashish ji, you know, may God bless you and give you all the strength, power, and his blessing so that you keep doing this good work. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.